And we're back! What's going on? It's Carlos from TechBeam with a look at your weekly Tech Rewind. In July, Mate started a crowdfunding campaign based on the success of their last electric bike. Next Generation promises improved performance at a more approachable price point. The new Mate X e-bike will come in three different varieties, the 250, the 250 Plus, and the 750. Now the naming scheme is going to refer to the size of the motor. Each bike is going to reach speeds up to 15 miles per hour, and the range of each bike is 35 to 55 miles on a single charge. The bikes feature disc brakes, a cycling computer, and USB charging port. And lastly, if you're wondering how much it's all going to cost you, the starting price of the Mate X is $2,199, but if you back them on their campaign, it's only going to cost you $799. One of the most annoying arbitrary limits of Spotify is the number of offline downloads you can have. Now the music streaming service has increased the cap from the previous 3,333 songs on a maximum of 3 devices. According to a report from Rolling Stone, the new limit has been raised to 10,000 songs that can be downloaded onto a maximum of 5 devices. That means you're now looking at a total song list of 50,000 songs. You see, at Spotify, we're always working on improving the experience for our users, a company spokesperson told Rolling Stone. Now, even with the old limitation being squashed, you're still going to have to deal with a 10,000 song limit on your personal library. Now, hopefully, the bump up in offline downloads will lead to a maximum library size being raised. Now, if you have smart plugs and you've ever thought to yourself, I wish I could plug more than one thing in at a time. Well, Casa may have solved that problem for you. They've come up with a power strip that can connect to Wi-Fi without the need for other hubs. The Casa Smart Wi-Fi power strip has 6 power sockets, which can be controlled through an app or by voice assistant, as well as 3 USB ports that always remain powered on. Plugs can be controlled individually, but unfortunately each USB port maxes out at 4 amps, meaning no fast charging. If the device sounds intriguing to you, you can pick it up online for $80. Now that may sound really expensive, but when you consider that each plug goes for around $25 compared to a single smart plug, it's actually a pretty reasonable deal. Recent rumors have spread that Apple's next generation iPad Pro will have a major upgrade in regards to I/O. The tablet will be switching from the proprietary Lightning connector to USB-C. With this news, there's also a rumored removal of the headphone jack, meaning there's going to be a higher reliance on USB-C headphones, and an 18-watt charger may also appear in the box. Now, with all these rumors, we're just going to have to wait and see until Apple makes another announcement, which is likely going to happen in October. Well, Microsoft is up to its old shenanigans again, testing a new Windows 10 feature that warns users not to install Chrome or Firefox. Microsoft is in the final stages right now of testing the Windows 10 October 2018 update, with testers spotting the new warning. You already have Microsoft Edge, the safer, faster browser for Windows 10, says a prompt. Now, according to The Verge, this is just going to be something that's temporary for now and is going to disappear in the final release of the update. Now, Microsoft regularly tests features over the course of its updates, but this prompt was not something that was mentioned in any of the company's blog posts, and not to mention, it's something that also appeared very late in the testing stages. This is not to say that this prompt is not going to appear in another update, but the decision is going to come down to customer feedback. While the new feature can be turned off, it's yet another example of the tech giant's use of ads and pop-ups in its latest OS. Now, it's not exactly super clear why Microsoft thinks that the new prompt is a good idea, as it's likely to annoy people rather than to convince them to switch to Edge. Well, we know Christmas is still a ways away, but if you're thinking about where to get your Christmas tree from this year, you might not actually have to look far. You see, according to the AP, Amazon, and yes, I said Amazon, is going to be selling and delivering 7-foot Christmas trees this holiday season. Oh, and before you ask, yes, they're eligible for Prime shipping. The trees will go on sale sometime in November, and buyers are going to have their choice between Douglas firs, Norfolk Island pines, and other options. A 7-foot Fraser fir will also go on sale for $115. The trees will ship in large boxes and won't include anything else in the box, including water, but your tree should be just fine as it's going to ship within 10 days of being cut down. This isn't the first time Amazon has sold live trees, but it's the first time the company will be offering full-size trees. Wreaths, garlands, and other holiday items are also going to be available, and Amazon will be giving customers the option to choose convenient delivery dates. And for anyone worried about an online competition, or about online competition that is, a spokesperson from the National Christmas Tree Association, and yes, that actually is a thing, says that web orders only made up about 1-2% of the 27 million trees that were sold last year. Because, well, apparently people just can't get enough of picking out their own fresh Christmas trees. And that's a look at your Weekly Tech Rewind. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe down below. Be sure to turn on that bell for notifications as well. That's going to do it for your Weekly Tech Rewind. My name is Ben Carlos, and we'll see you next time here on TechBeam.